Hello everyone, welcome to my channel BioQuest Biochemistry Classes. Today I'm going to start a new topic, that is glycolysis. This is the basic metabolic pathway of dissolution of 6 carbon containing glucose molecule to 3 carbon containing pyruvate molecule. This method has 3 irreversible steps, 2 substrate level phosphorylation reactions and 3 key regulatory enzymes. Now the objectives of this session will be importance of glycolysis, key regulatory steps of glycolysis, differences between hexokinase and glucokinase, and MCQ relevant to this topic in NEET PG, INISET and upcoming next exams. So the importance of glycolysis. Glycolysis is almost occurring in all the cells and in the cytoplasm. This is the sole pathway for source of energy for matured erythrocytes or RBC, as they are devoid of mitochondria. It has both aerobic and anaerobic fates. The muscles get energy via anaerobic glycolysis during strenuous exercise, and this is the lactate which is formed that gives rise to muscle pain. Glycolysis is the metabolic pathway for catabolism of glucose in cancer cells and the malignant cell. Glycolysis also serves as a source of glycerol and carbon skeletal of non-essential amino. Now, what are the steps of glycolysis? The first step, the 6 carbon containing glucose is phosphorylated to glucose 6 phosphate via the enzyme hexokinase. Why hexokinase? 6 carbon hexose is phosphorylated. Transfer of a phosphorus or phosphate moiety, so the enzyme is named as hexokinase. And in this reaction, ATP is converted to ADP. Now, in the next step, glucose-6-phosphate is converted to fructose-6-phosphate. As we all know, glucose and fructose are isomers, functional isomer. One is aldose, second one is ketose. So what will be the enzyme? Phosphohexose isomerase. In the third step, the fructose-6-phosphate is again phosphorylated to fructose-1,6-bisphosphate. And the enzyme is phosphofructokinase 1. The first step is irreversible. The enzyme, as I have shown it with red color, hexokinase. And the third reaction with the enzyme phosphofructokinase is irreversible. So among the 3 irreversible enzymes, 2 already you have known. But the hexokinase, though it is an irreversible enzyme, this glucose-6-phosphate is not the first committed step of glycolysis. Why so? Not committed because this glucose-6-phosphate have multiple fate. It may enter the hexose monophosphate shunt. It may go to the glycogen synthesis. So this is not the committed step. Whereas fructose-1,6-bisphosphate, once it is formed, it will be channelized to the glycolytic pathway, and this is the committed step of glycolysis. Moreover, phosphofructokinase 1 is also the rate limiting step or the pacemaker enzyme of glycolytic pathway. Now, this fructose-1,6-bisphosphate also requires conversion of one ATP molecule to another ADP molecule. So, 2 ATP molecules are consumed. Now, this fructose-1,6-bisphosphate is cleaved by aldolase to 3 carbon containing 2 molecules. What are those? Glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Dihydroxyacetone phosphate, it is in ketose, whereas glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, it is an aldose. Now, this dihydroxyacetone phosphate can get converted to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. This is a reversible step by the action of the enzyme triose phosphate isomerase. Now this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, for each molecule glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is acted upon by glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. As the name suggests, it is an oxidoreductase, that means class 1 category of enzyme. So it will require NAD as the coenzyme. Now this NAD will get reduced to NADH and it will require inorganic phosphate, and this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate will get converted to 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. Now this 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate will be acted upon by phosphoglycerate kinase and it will get converted to 3-phosphoglycerate. So here one ATP will be produced. Mind it will be produced. Now this 3-phosphoglycerate will get isomerized by the enzyme mutase to 2-phosphoglycerate. 2-phosphoglycerate will be cleaved and one molecule of water will be removed by the action of the enzyme enolase, and this 2-phosphoglycerate will be converted to phosphoenol pyruvate. Now this phosphoenol pyruvate will again be acted upon by the enzyme pyruvate kinase, and with the formation of one molecule of ATP, this phosphoenol pyruvate will get converted to pyruvate. So here you can jolly well see the three reactions and the three enzymes that are marked in red are the irreversible or the key regulatory enzymes of glycolytic pathway. Now coming to the importance, the first one, hexokinase, the first irreversible reaction, phosphofructokinase 1, the second irreversible reaction, and the pyruvate kinase 1, the third irreversible reaction. How to remember? Medical science is only full of mnemonics. So I have made it like that. HP printer is now number 1. So HP1 printer, H for hexokinase, P for number 1 printer, and the now you can see here that this NADH will go to the electron transport chain and there will be production of ATP molecule. Each NADH molecule will give rise to production of 2.5 molecule, and the reactions where there are productions of ATP, they are also known as substrate level phosphorylation. I will discuss it later. What are those substrate level phosphorylations? Now, how many ATPs are produced in glycolysis? In case of aerobic glycolysis, I have said it in the starting of the session that glycolysis are of two types, aerobic and anaerobic. If it is aerobic glycolysis, number of ATP consumed is 2 in the first step and in the third step. Now, number of ATP produced for each molecule of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is, for one molecule of NADH, 2.5 molecule of ATP are produced, and 2 molecules of ATP for the reaction catalyzed by phosphoglycerate kinase and pyruvate kinase. These two reactions are substrate level phosphorylation, refers to the formation of ATP from ADP and a phosphorylated intermediate rather than from ADP and inorganic phosphate, as we can see in cases of oxidative phosphorylation. The amount of ATP that is generated by glycolysis is relatively low. Now, so for 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde, 2 into 2.5, that is for the NADH molecule generated, plus 2 into 2 equal to 9. So 9 molecules are credited. Already we have been debited by 2 molecules of ATP. So net ATP produced is 7 in cases of aerobic glycolysis. In cases of anaerobic glycolysis, pyruvate is again converted to lactate. This is the fate of pyruvate in cases of anaerobic glycolysis, and the enzyme is lactate dehydrogenase. So the NADH that is produced in the reaction of glycerol dehydrophosphate, that will be reutilized. Thus the total number of ATP that will be produced will be 2 molecules. Why so? Because NADH that is produced by glycerol dehydrophosphate production will be again reutilized. So 2 molecules of ATP for each molecule of glycerol dehydrophosphate reaction catalyzed by the substrate level phosphorylation reaction. So net production of ATP. Differences between hexokinase and glucokinase. This is a common question in the Viva. Hexokinase and glucokinase. As the name suggests, hexokinase, that means that will act on any of the hexoses. It will phosphorylate any of the hexoses. Glucokinase specific and can phosphorylate glucose only. Hexokinase is more stable, whereas glucokinase is physiologically more labile, found almost in all tissues, found in adult liver and only in beta cells of pancreas. This hexokinase that is inhibited by the product glucose-6-phosphate, whereas glucokinase is not inhibited by glucose-6-phosphate. Hexokinase, the KM is low. KM stands for Michaelis constant. It is Michaelis constant, not Michaelis-Menten constant. It is low. So inversely, the affinity will be high. Whereas in glucokinase, the KM is high, so the affinity will be low. In hexokinase, it is not inducible by insulin, whereas glucokinase, it is insulin. Hexokinase has two variants, 1 and 2. Hexokinase 2 variant is inducible by insulin. Now the regulation of glycolysis, the key regulatory enzyme. Remember the mnemonic HP1 printer. So H hexokinase, insulin, hexokinase 2 has been affected by insulin, inhibition by glucose-6-phosphate and glucagon. PFK1 that is activated by insulin, AMP, fructose-2,6-bisphosphate and PFK2, glucagon, ATP and citrate are the inhibitors. For pyruvate kinase, insulin, fructose-1,6-bisphosphate are activators, glucagon and ATP are. Now questions in prof exam from this topic, they may come as LAQ, SAQ or MEQ, any form. These are the questions. Irreversible steps of glycolysis, what are the net amount of ATP produced and mechanism of inhibition of enolase by fluoride, or why fluoride vial is added for glucose estimation. Because this enolase, this binds to the magnesium bivalent cation that is required for its activity. The fluoride ion binds to the magnesium bivalent cation and thereby inhibits the activity of the enolase. That's why fluoride is added in the vial that is required for estimation of plasma glucose concentration, so that the glucose concentration does not get lowered over time, as RBC depends solely on glycolysis for their energy requirement. The key regulators of glycolysis, the differences between hexokinase and glycolysis, and the substrate level phosphorylation reactions. Now MCQ, this is very common topic, or rather a high yield topic from where MCQ comes. Almost every year or alternative year in NEET, PG or INISET. And another high yield topic is galactosemia, the link of which is given in the I button here. So let's start the MCQ. In glycolysis, inorganic phosphate used in a reaction is catalyzed by, the options were enolase, pyruvate kinase, glyceraldehyde, 3-phosphate dehydrogenase and aldolase. The answer is glyceraldehyde, 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. This is the only reaction which requires inorganic phosphate. In biochemistry, there are few reactions which require inorganic phosphate in the reactions for generation of phosphorylated products. Question number 2. Inhibitors of glycolysis are all except fluoride, fluoroacetate, arsenite, iodoacetate. So the answer is fluoride. We all know it is a known inhibitor of glycolysis. It inhibits the enzyme enolase. It is fluoroacetate. Arsenate, it can replace inorganic phosphate in the step of the glycolysis that produced 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate from glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Therefore, glycolysis proceeds, but ATP that would be generated from 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate is lost, and arsenate is an uncoupler of glycolysis. Thereby, it is an inhibitor of glycolysis. Iodoacetate irreversibly inhibits the glycolytic enzyme glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. So, answer of exclusion is, in conversion of glucose to glucose 6-phosphate in glycolysis, true is glucokinase has low Km, hexokinase is found in the liver, glucokinase is induced by insulin, hexokinase is not specific for glucose. This is a question that has appeared in INISET exam. Glucokinase has high Km and low affinity. Hexokinase is found in almost all the cell. It is glucokinase that is found in adult liver cells and beta pancreatic cells. Glucokinase is induced by insulin. This option is correct. And hexokinase, as the name suggests, it is not specific for glucose. So, two options are correct. Anaerobic glycolysis of which of this produces 3 ATPs per unit of glucose consumed? Amino acid, fructose, galactose, glycogen. The answer is glycogen. Why? Because in glycogen, the end product is glucose 1-phosphate. So, the first step in which we require an ATP for the conversion of glucose to glucose 6-phosphate is not required. So, the net production of ATP will be 1 unit higher, that is 3 ATP will be produced. The calculation is given here. Which activates kinase of glycolysis? Now, let us go to a thumb rule. Any metabolic pathway that reduces the plasma glucose concentration will be activated by insulin. Thumb rule. And how does insulin act? Insulin acts by dephosphorylation. So, let us look at glycolysis. What does glycolysis do? It converts the glucose moiety 6-carbon to 3-carbon pyruvate moiety. That means there will be dissolution of plasma glucose. It is reduced. So, what will activate it? Insulin. Inhibition of glycolysis by increased supply of oxygen is called pasture effect. Where there is increased supply of oxygen, glycolysis is inhibited, that is called pasture effect. Warburg effect is seen in malignant cell where despite of adequate presence of oxygen, they depend on anaerobic glycolysis. Which of the enzyme of glycolysis is a part of gluconeogenesis? Pyruvate kinase, phosphofructokinase, hexokinase, phosphoglycerate kinase. So, let us go back to the mnemonic. HP1 printer, phosphofructokinase 1, hexokinase and pyruvate kinase. These three are the irreversible steps. So, they need to be again converted to some other products by other enzymes. So, only the enzyme that catalyzes a reversible step is phosphoglycerate kinase. So phosphoglycerate kinase is the option. Thank you for watching my channel BioQuest. If you feel that it is good watching, do like, subscribe and share and keep watching. Thank you.